our story begins where the cable cars climb, at Mason and California streets on Nob Hill. The Intercontinental Mark Hopkins, one of the most prestigious hotels in the world. 300 feet up, no matter where you look, the view is breathtaking.
70 years ago, this was the highest point in downtown San Francisco. Why don't you come on inside? We'll go back and take a look at 1948.
It all started right here. This is where it began, in this great old hotel attic. KPIX threw a switch, and we went on the air live.
And in black and white, the date, December 22nd, 1948. On the roof, KPIX installed the Bay Area's first TV broadcast antenna. In the attic, master control, where engineers kept a close eye on transmissions.
To make sure that it has the proper quality and so that the viewers will enjoy the best possible picture.
On the ground floor, the studios hummed with talent. The station gained a reputation for tackling ambitious live remotes.
Doing a television remote was a big affair, regardless of who was in front of the camera.
10 days after our first broadcast on New Year's Day, KPIX broadcast the first televised East-West Shrine Game at Kezar Stadium.
The President of the United States of America.
In 1951, the first live coast-to-coast television broadcast of a major news event. From the San Francisco Opera House, President Harry Truman officially ends World War II.
I'm glad to welcome you to this conference for the signing of the Treaty of Peace with Japan.
KPIX originated the coverage for CBS News.
May we have the Pacific Coast, please?
KPIX cameras also helped legendary journalist Edward R. Murrow with his first episode of See It Now.
Francisco, could you use what you call, I think, a Zoomar lens and close in on the bridge a little?
Roger.
You think you're going to know your daddy when you see him again?
I think so.
In 1953, at the end of the Korean War, KPIX showed the nation these live images from Pier 2 at Fort Mason. Hundreds of POWs on a huge ship came down the gangway and into the arms of loved ones. In the crush, Sergeant Dixon from San Jose.
Could you look into the camera so all the other folks in San Jose and the USA can take a look at you?
The demand for bigger and better broadcasts exploded. KPIX soon outgrew the Mark Hopkins.
Construction, as you see, is rapidly underway.
To fill the need, we built the Bay Area's first modern broadcasting facility. The location, the corner, Van Ness and Greenwich.
We're constructing a new transmitter and a new antenna.
The transmitter and antenna moved to Mount Sutro. KPIX then went full throttle.
It's a number of plants.
Brand new shows included Adventure School.
Howdy. Join Rowdy and myself.
And Marshall J. with Rowdy the Dog for kids.
It's called the Oliver Twist.
Dick Stewart's Dance Party for Teeny Boppers.
90 minutes a day, 6 days a week with teenagers dancing.
Del Courtney's live afternoon variety show.
You can buy this
complete with in-studio car commercials.
$29.88.
And an old favorite, Teletours.
Playland at the beach.
Which brought the Bay Area into your living room.
Live from San Francisco.
KPIX was also a pioneer in TV news. In 1959, we broadcast the first half-hour news show in Northern California. The noon news featured John Weston and girl on the beat, Wanda Ramey.
Do you think they should come out?
Ramey was the first female newscaster in the Western United States.
The big news.
Then in 1962, the big news arrived. The Bay Area's first full hour of nightly news.
And I understand you have some two suspects in custody, is that true?
In 1966, KPIX hired the talented Ben Williams, one of the first African-American reporters in the country.
He loved looking into things. He loved investigating things. He loved understanding things.
Belva Davis. Friday
we then hired Belva Davis, the first black female journalist in the West. She came to TV with no training. but would leave with seven Emmys, becoming one of the most respected and trusted journalists in the nation.
I worked with so many talented people in those early days at PIX. It was just amazing.
During the 60s and 70s, KPIX covered it all. The good, the bad, and the ugly.
We're not going to play by their rules!
From the student protests,
and the Kennedy headquarters when the shooting took place,
Robert Kennedy's assassination, Patty Hearst, the Black Panthers, Jonestown, the Milk Moscone murders, to the hippies, counterculture, and overall craziness.
Today's artwork will finally be made into a trophy called a Booby Prize.
Remember the Beatles at Candlestick Park?
Which one of the Beatles is your favorite?
George!
At the time, everything was shot and edited on film.
You had to give that film time to develop.
Eyewitness News.
KPIX News anchor Wendy Takuda. She was the first Asian American to anchor a Monday through Friday primetime newscast in the Bay Area. Her co-anchor, Oakland native Dave McElhattan.
Well, we had a fast landing there, didn't we? Good evening, I'm Dave McElhattan.
Mac, as we called him, was a radio broadcaster who took TV by storm.
Nightcast.
Along with Wayne Walker with sports and Joel Bartlett with the weather, we soared to number one.
It was a golden time. There's no question about it. It was a golden time for local television in this beautiful city.
In 1976, the technology changed KPIX forever when a new show hit the air.
Our show was the very first show to use video out in the field.
It was called
Evening Magazine.
We were not in a studio. We took the video everywhere, and it was not film, as Jan points out.
3/4-inch tape.
The newsroom soon switched over to videotape. The Van Ness Studios churned out even more shows, which included People Are Talking with Ann Frazier and Ross McGowan.
Oh, that is good to be back.
KPIX would soon outgrow the Van Ness and Greenwich location.
That old building, the old TV station, is gone. It was demolished back in 2006 to make way for this new condo complex. But by that time, KPIX had moved on to its new location back in 1979.
We picked up our studios and headed to 855 Battery Street, an old warehouse for the American Biscuit Company, later known as the National Biscuit Company, or Nabisco for short.
I'm Wendy Takuda in our new Channel 5 studios. Eyewitness News is next.
Where cookies and candy were once made, we now made the news.
We'll start analyzing everything.
Anchor Kate Kelly.
When I first walked in, the first thing that struck me was it was beautiful, clean, and there were so many people.
For the next four decades, KPIX covered the Bay Area. News, weather, sports, social unrest, technology, politics, lifestyle, entertainment, the environment, AIDS, big events, small events, human tragedies, fires, droughts, major catastrophes,
just within this
and of course,
hour,
breaking
California
news.
Has
when a big breaker would happen, you would hear it immediately. The whole newsroom, the decibels would go up.
KPIX brought you the news from near and far, the occupied territories, the fall of the Berlin Wall, even Africa.
Horrible, horrible thing had occurred there.
Anchor Dana King traveled to Rwanda to report on the horrific genocide.
Helping people understand what happened, why it happened, who it happened to, and to also understand that it could happen anywhere.
Before our newsroom became digital, crews lugged around big recorders and portable cameras in the field. Then came the computers.
And we had to have the typewriters. We kept the typewriters in case the computers crashed. And in fact, one day they did.
The technology improved. Smaller, better, faster.
We had to change our game. We had to change the way that we told the news. It was more, became more immediate.
These days, just ask anchor and reporter Hank Plant.
You can do a live shot in a newscast using an iPhone, and you can put it on a selfie stick, and you can do that from anywhere in the world.
Today, we stream news updates all day long on 9 digital platforms, exclusive cameras on top of the Salesforce Tower, as well as SkyDrone 5 providing unparalleled views. Whether breaking news, weather, sports, consumer, or investigative reports, we've got you covered. From the heights of Nob Hill to the flats near the Barbary Coast. Here's to another 70 years. I'm Ken Bastida, KPIX 5.